And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We are headed back to the Nexus. And yeah, getting choppy frame rate. Exit. Well, that exits the map. Okay, never mind. Okay, I just have to go space system view. I got it. That's the asteroid. Cluster map. Zenghe. Ooh. So the Nexus is here. Okay. So they've made it so that you can skip this. But I'd want to watch it. Especially because it reminds me of Doctor Who.
Familiar territory.
The Nexus has been here for months. Still not enough time to survey all.
Actually, I'm not completely sure if you can skip that or if it's just planet to planet. I know this that animation's a lot quicker than the planet to planet. First, you have to, they have to, you know, have the animation of you leaving the planet and then going to the next one. So in the future, I'll be skipping that, like, repeated occurrences of that. But whenever I skip from one planet to another where, you know, I haven't done it before, I'm gonna keep it in. I'm gonna watch it. If you guys don't mind. And there be that Nexus. And we can go like that. I'd say home again, but this really isn't our home, right? But Nexus again? So we have a few quests to finish up here. Unless they're not finishing up and we're just going to be continuing. Skip?
Pathfinder, is it true? We're settling Eos.
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space.
Different,
Lieutenant
yeah.
Lieutenant Syax, Kendros's aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
I'm just doing my job.
They've got a Pathfinder again. This is what we do.
And you've done it splendidly.
Well, thank
Professor
you.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieved with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible.
Yeah, it was fun.
With new scientific talent waking up, we'll unravel those mysteries. The whole Nexus will benefit.
Hmm. Well, this proves our resilience, then.
We've taken some hard knocks. But this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.
A whole new world! With lots of cat to see. Alright, never mind.
Watch your tone. You saw what happened to the Krogan.
But we need this equipment.
Well, you're not getting it. Stop making frivolous requests.
It's not a frivolous request. Properly functioning air filters are at...
Frivolous. You'll just have to make do.
We can't fix the station breathing bad air.
Does she have an itch on her back? That's the cutest Solarian, like, Solarian female I've ever heard. Del Jason?
Your incompetence isn't my problem. Just do your job.
What's going on here?
What do you want?
With an attitude like that, I'm tempted to snap back. But no, that didn't look very fun for you.
Sounds like you're having a rough day.
You saw that, huh? Oh, I'm sorry I snapped at you. The way Spender treats me? Everyone, I'm just... so angry. Hmm. I don't understand how he's in any position of authority.
So female Solarians look just like male Solarians. Unless they have red rimmed eyes or something like that. Which, for all I know, the other Solarians do as well. Is he always like that?
He was pretty abusive towards you. Is that normal?
Yes, he's horrible. Working with him is a total nightmare. Just last week, he tried to redirect some of the supplies we need to keep the stasis pods going.
Why?
I have no idea. But if Kesh hadn't stepped in and threatened to airlock him, it would have been a disaster.
Cool.
He's always like that. Making bad decisions, driving the Krogan away, treating people like scum when no one's watching.
Huh. How can I help?
Maybe there's something I can do.
A man like that's bound to have some dirt. I wish Tan and Addison could see it. Things have gotten so bad that Kesh had to literally kick him out of engineering.
How literal are we talking here?
Boot to ass. Oh, it was glorious. We need him gone, but as incompetent as Spender is at his job, he's insanely good at keeping it.
That's Spender?
Kesh can tell you more.
Yeah, we heard about Spender. I can't go back here? I want to man the register. Someone was being an ass. Hey, Vetra.
What are you doing with that ship? That part doesn't go there. I gotta tell Kesh to do something about her mechanics.
I thought you were talking to me.
Damn, Ryder, you just missed a good show.
Huh, you missed another good show.
One of the alarms malfunctioned, and we thought it was an attack. It didn't take long to figure it out, but in that time, they managed to scramble at least half the station's defenses.
Well, you missed Agent Spender over there. Another malfunction?
Why are the alarms still malfunctioning?
Probably a leftover issue from when the Scourge fried systems. It's not that bad. I once worked in a building with a fire alarm that would glitch every other week.
Only every other? I could tell you some stories about that.
We headed out soon? You ever just think I miss home? Every time I do, I feel guilty about it.
I don't know. Maybe I should have stayed home.
This is your home, Buster.
Tan just came through here on a tear. Have you ever seen a Solarian power walking? Hilarious.
Look, this isn't going to work. Just give me another chance.
No, we're done.
Anything else to say?
Hey, Ryder.
You know, I always try to pick up conversations from people. I would never get anywhere. You are crazy.
You can proceed to the waiting area. Thank you. My pleasure. Next. And what's your name?
I know. Red Ring of Death means you can't go in. Have I talked to this Avena here? I don't remember there being an Avena here.
How may I assist?
Alright, they're all grayed out. Never mind.
That's all.
It has been my pleasure.
We can go in there, I think. Cultural Center. So what's in here? New location. Turian VI, really?
It's an honor to meet you, citizen of Andromeda. My people are the Turians.
Correct.
It will be a privilege to tell you about them.
Well, I do know plenty about Turians, but maybe I'll learn something new. Tell me more.
Okay.
Turians are a highly disciplined race who value service to others. No one places personal needs ahead of the greater whole. Public works serve as a focal point of our society. We believe it's our duty to better our species.
Tell me about your history.
What's Turian history like?
The history of my people is proof that peace eventually wins out. Disagreements among species turned into lasting friendships.
Humans?
When Turians first met humans,
there you go.
There was a misunderstanding between us that could have had disastrous consequences.
First contact war?
But with patience and restraint, humans and Turians eventually joined together in a mutually beneficial partnership. We look forward to doing the same in Andromeda.
It was disastrous for a little while. What's the Turian homeworld like?
Where do you come from?
Turians live on a planet known as Power. The atmosphere's weak magnetic field shaped our evolution into the life form you see today. Our signature carapace, the hard, exterior shell you see on Turians, is actually metal. It protects us from the intense rays of Power and Sun.
Huh. You know? I wasn't aware that it's actually metal. I thought it was some kind of like bone-like structure, you know, exoskeleton kind of thing.
The pleasure of meeting you has been mine. One that I hope other Turians will soon enjoy.
So they're total metalheads. So what about this one? This one is inactive. We have VIs for all these races. I'm like, what race is that? So, Asari VI.
Welcome, native of Andromeda. My people are known as Asari. It would be my pleasure to tell you about our kind.
Tell me more.
Okay.
Very well. Asari are the oldest civilized race in the Milky Way galaxy. Among my people, diplomacy and cooperation are prized over war or conflict.
What's your history like?
What's Asari history like?
Close.
Thousands of years ago, we played an important role in founding the Citadel Council, the seat of government for our home galaxy. In the ensuing centuries, Asari placed great value on cooperation and collaboration. Many species looked to us for leadership and guidance. Due to our lifespan, sometimes reaching 1,000 years of age, we are patient in our decisions and prefer long-term solutions over short-term gains.
And where do you come from?
Where do you come from?
Asari come from a planet known as Thessia, which many consider the crown jewel of the Milky Way. It's a thriving world blessed with prosperity and peace, and the center of the largest economy in the galaxy. With the high concentration of element zero on Thessia, Asari evolved powerful biotic abilities. It is considered a hallmark of our species.
You know, the funny thing is, after Mass Effect 3, I'm sure they rebuilt, but we're over 600 years in the future. For all we know, Thessia could no longer even be there. Some new threat might have come along and blown the entire planet out of space, and we wouldn't know.
Farewell. We look forward to forging new bonds with our friends in Andromeda. The wisdom you share is our reward.
Krogan VI.
Hi there. Thanks for stopping by. I'm a Krogan. Are you interested in hearing more about my people?
Okay.
Of course you are. We may look scary, but don't let that worry you.
What? You are scary.
We're living in a harsh world. We're a species that knows how to thrive, even under the worst conditions.
Tell them how you blew up your own home world over and over again. What's Krogan history like?
What's Krogan history like?
Nailed it.
Powerful, you might say. Growing up in our neighborhood, only the toughest survived. That usually meant a lot of fighting. You'll hear stories, so no sense covering it up. We once had a great society, but I'm ashamed to say, we squandered it.
Okay.
It's why a lot of Krogan are here in Andromeda now. They're the smart ones. The ones looking for peace and a fresh start.
I hope so. And what was the other one? Where do you come from?
Where do you come from?
An ugly rock called Tichanka. No sense lies. It's not a planet most people want to visit. We had predators, nasty weather, and not much else. But it gave us our identity. Forced us to adapt and evolve. Everything about us is built for survival. How many species do you know that have a pair of spare lungs just in case?
Or not only that.
Tentacles?
Oh, there you go. I didn't think he was going to throw that in there. Okay, thank you.
Thanks for chatting. We're all looking forward to meeting our new neighbors.
Take care of your quads over there. Solarian VI. I'm talking about Vortex and Dutch could use ingredients.
Greetings, inhabitant of Andromeda. I'm a Solarian.
Tell me more, tell me more.
Okay.
Solarians are considered among the brightest scientific minds of the Milky Way. We're known for our quick thinking, technological savvy, and intellectual powers of deduction.
What's Solarian history like?
Cooperating with the Asari, we were the second species in the Milky Way to help form a galactic government, the Citadel Council. From time to time, we also guided other species, such as the Krogan, to better channel their natural gifts towards worthy pursuits.
Yeah, they appreciate that.
The careful application of science and intellect is the key to improving the quality of life for all.
Where do you come from?
Solarians originate from a world known as Sirkesh. Sirkesh. It's a tropical planet covered with oceans and rainforests. As an amphibious species, we're at home in Sirkesh's lush jungles. But with our technological advancements, we can adapt to nearly any environment. We look forward to studying the wonders of Andromeda and the rich diversity our galaxy has to offer.
They used to lick their eyes.
It's been my pleasure. Rest assured, the people of Andromeda have nothing to fear from Solarians.
I never said they did. Human VI.
Hello there. I'm a human being. If you'd like to know more about my people, just ask.
I'm a human being. Now, why don't the others say that they're a Krogan being? Or a Solarian being? Okay.
Okay.
Good to hear. Humanity is a diverse species. You may notice different skin colors and religious beliefs among our people. Yet we don't let those differences come between us. We'd rather celebrate our diversity, rather than fight over it.
So what, you're saying the other races aren't diverse? You're a racist. What's human history like?
Humanity is a young people compared to many of the other Milky Way races. We didn't discover spaceflight until much later. But what we lack in age, we make up for with enthusiasm and a pioneer spirit. We'd like to think we can teach our fellow travelers a few new tricks.
Where do you come from? Earth? Never heard of it.
Where do you come from?
Humans come from a planet called Earth. It's a beautiful blue world, with everything from oceans to jungles, snowy mountain peaks to deserts. It's also an oasis of biological diversity. Scientists calculate Earth contains nearly 9 million unique animal and plant species.
Yeah, well, the Krogan have Varan. And I'm sure there's plenty of diversity among them as well. Nice doing business with you.
I'm glad you stopped by. Next time you see a human, ask about ice cream.
Ice cream?
It's one of the many great things we bring to Andromeda.
Well, I gotta admit, though. The other race is having to go without ice cream. That's sad. So there's another race to be filled in over here.
They're happy to answer any questions.
No spoilers, guys, on who that might be, please. And possibly one here as well? Is that even supposed to be? Cool. I am the new human VI. Well, there's another one over here as well. It sounds ridiculous. Let's check out the Ark. Oh.
This is Ark Hyperion, one of several ships that made the long voyage from the Milky Way galaxy to Andromeda.
Yes,
the
it is.
The thousands of colonists aboard have come in peace, united by their dream of a better life in your beautiful galaxy.
They sure have.
You need not fear their arrival. We are all citizens of the universe, eager to be your friend.
Who is this made for? Because everyone here came from... Never mind. I guess this is for other races to visit? Cultural Center Liaison. Oh, Garson? Liaison. Hail, Liaison. Oh, I can't... Oh, now you're moving away. I need to get to the front of you.
Welcome
so
to the Cultural Exchange Center. Please have a look around.
Thank you.
We're just get Pathfinder. I'm glad you could stop
stuff.
By. Pardon the dust while we set everything up.
It's okay. We are all made of star stuff. What is this place?
What goes on here?
The Cultural Center is a place where new races we've met can visit and exchange ideas. They can learn more about the Milky Way species, while we foster an air of cooperation and understanding. We're just getting everything ready. Hopefully it won't be long before we have our first visitors.
Hmm. Notice that the tone of her voice changes like that? Tell me about yourself.
How did you get this job?
I was a sociologist in the Milky Way. While there were plenty of cultures to study, the books on them had all been written. There was nothing new I could add. So when I heard about the initiative, I signed up right away. The idea of meeting new people, seeing how they've evolved, adapted to life's challenges, I couldn't resist.
Hmm. Do you have any info on the cat?
Have you heard anything about the cat?
Unfortunately, yes. Now, that's a species we won't be inviting here anytime soon.
Ooh, because I was worried there.
I hoped our encounters would be peaceful, but I suppose that was too much to ask.
Hmm. Okay, well thanks.
Thanks.
Of course, our hope is that you'll make friends in the cluster and send them our way.
We'll see.
And when you have a second, check back with me on a favor I'd like to ask.
Well, I'm here now, so why don't I ask you now?
Pathfinder, do you have a moment? We, need to explain you.
Need to explain me?
Explain me?
Our new VI over there is meant to describe the role of our Pathfinders, but it just lost all its settings in a crash.
That
if
one?
You could fix them, that would really help us out. Just talk to the VI, and it'll do the rest.
Okay.
Thanks.
Of course.
But of course, I'm assuming that it's this gray one over here.
I'm Gian Garth, founder of the...
Hail, Broken VI.
Welcome to the setup for your Pathfinder information only app.
Setup.
I am programmed with all relevant data. However, you must identify which information I should prioritize. First, select your preferred voice and appearance, male or female.
Female. Don't tell me I'm, like, doing your facial optimization as well. Please, no.
Female, please.
Very well said. Which aspect of the Pathfinder's role should be highlighted? Exploration and discovery, or first contact with new species?
Hmm. My first choice is exploration, but first contact, why not?
Meeting new species.
Very well. Next, should I emphasize the role of the Pathfinder team, or their partner AI?
The team.
Go with the Pathfinder's team.
Very well said. Finally, should I provide career advice to future Pathfinders, or in honor of former Pathfinders?
Huh, can't we have both? I'm torn. Really have to acknowledge those who's come before, especially her own father. But we also need to pave the way for the future. Career advice.
I want you to give career advice.
Setup complete. Would you like to keep these settings?
Yeah, that's pretty neat.
It all sounds good to me.
Thank you for choosing this Pathfinder information, Fia. Implementing changes.
The Nexus is a place of friendship and cooperation. We're glad you could visit.
Okay. When will it actually be fixed so it looks like the others?
Tell me about Pathfinders.
Pathfinders are among the first to encounter new species, making them first contact ambassadors, as well as explorers. They work hard to ensure everyone knows the initiative is peaceful.
How does one become a Pathfinder, other than their father dying?
How does someone usually become a Pathfinder?
Usually.
The minimum requirements are survival training, AI compatibility testing, and military or scientific experience. If you're interested, submit your candidacy to the Pathfinder headquarters.
I'll be sure to do that. Allies?
Tough job. Do Pathfinders have help?
The team?
Each Pathfinder has a team of talented specialists, drawn from
okay, thank you.
If you see a Pathfinder on your travels, be sure to say hello.
Yeah, next time I come across a mirror, I'll wave at it. Garson. I want to talk to this Garson, but just want to look to see if there's any goodies back here. That needs to be fixed, something going on down there. Oh, Jan Garson, the one who passed away.
Hello there, Paper. I'm Jan Garson, the founder of the Andromeda Initiative. I thought you might like to hear more about our plans.
Sure.
Okay.
Great. If you're seeing this, it means our Pathfinders have done their job and made new friends in the galaxy. Welcome to the Nexus.
Why isn't she over there?
Arrived at ease. Seeing our arcs arrive in your neighborhood probably raised some concerns. I'm happy to address them.
Yeah, why did you come here? You're not welcome here. You've ruined your own lands. I have a quest reference.
Why did he leave the Milky Way?
I get that question a lot. Many of us have a deep curiosity that needs to know what else is out there. Our own Milky Way is just one tiny speck in a universe full of mysteries. And speaking for myself, the thought of exploring those mysteries in Andromeda was a call to adventure I could not resist.
Unfortunately, it ended in your demise. What are your intentions?
What are you planning to do in this galaxy?
Great question. I'd be worried about that too. I can assure you, we have no hostile intentions whatsoever.
Oh, good.
We're pilgrims who simply want to live in peace. We're eager to learn about new cultures, new ideas, and share our own with you. But we understand trust needs to be earned, no matter what galaxy you're in.
That's right.
And the initiative looks forward to doing just that.
Well, you better work on it.
Thank you for taking the time to listen. On behalf of my fellow Milky Way travelers, we couldn't be more excited about what the future holds for all of us.
Hopefully better than what her future ended up being.
The Nexus is a place of friendship and cooperation.
Docking area. Have I been here? Alright, believe it or not, I've spent almost the entire game in that cultural exchange center. So I'm going to log off here and then we're going to explore some more. I was supposed to go there, or is that my, my waypoint? No. I'm just supposed to go there, apparently. Don't know why. And there's question marks. Apparently I can go down there. They've opened up some stuff, and we have quests to do. Oh, I need to go behind me, kind of, and talk to Dr. Aradana. So thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.